Greetings. Great day, everybody. This is Jacob, your insightful marketer, delivering another insightful educational video in regards to crypto. Right now, I wanted to take the time to show you how you can download and set up your crypto.com DeFi wallet app. And this is different from the crypto.com centralized wallet. And there are two different ones for two different reasons, but for the most part, the DeFi or decentralized finance, which means it's not centralized, it's going to give you more control and more security over your cryptocurrency or your funds. So it's very, very important that you have your own keys, because if you do not have your own keys, that means that you can lose your funds at any given moment. My experience, there are times where I did have money in an exchange. I did not have the keys to the crypto. I woke up and I found that the website was down. It wasn't up for half the day. Then an announcement came out and said that they don't know when the exchange is going to come back up. So it never came back up and I lost my money. So I learned the hard way that it's important to own your keys. You own your crypto. And so I'm going to show you how you get your keys for the DeFi wallet app and what you need to do with that list and how to protect it and how to move around and maneuver in the back of your DeFi wallet app. So with that being said, let's go to the App Store for Apple users. If you are a Android user, you will go to the Google Play app and you will type in what I'm going to type into this app right now. So I'm going to go to the App Store. I go to crypto.com DeFi wallet. And when I hit enter, it's going to pull up the crypto.com DeFi wallet. It's going to have the white background with the blue lion logo face on the front. I already have mine, so I can hit open, but you would hit get. And when you hit get, it's going to download it into your phone. And it's going to show you the next step. So once it has downloaded into your phone and you hit the logo, you will be able to see this page here. And this is shows you some information about how good it is to connect, welcomes you, it's secure, it's flexible. But you're going to have two options on the bottom. You want to go to the top option, which says create a new wallet. So you hit that. And you're going to hit the box right there. It says I've read and accepted terms of service, so forth, so on. And then you hit continue. It talks to you about what the recovery phrase is. You've seen what I've said in other videos, and or you've heard me discuss about how important it is to have your 12, your 24 or 32 key phrases. This app will give you 12. But what's a recovery phrase? It's phrases that you should have access to and only you. No one else should have access to it, because if they do, they can take your money from you, basically. But you control it. Why do you need it? Because it's like a key, and if you lose it, you will never be able to get your assets back, as crypto.com does not keep a copy. So you are the bank. You are the person that keeps the keys to your funds. You are responsible, and you alone, not the bank, not the principal, not the neighbor next door. You control that. So you need to keep it in a safe place and after you write it down. So with that being said, it's getting a new sequence of names or phrases. And what you're going to do is you're going to write this down. So I'm going to hit reveal my recovery phrase. On the top, it says that crypto.com staff members or people who say they work at crypto.com, they will never ask you for your phrases. If they do, they're trying to scam you. So don't give these out to anybody at all. Make sure no one's looking at your screen when you're writing this stuff down, and keep it in a safe place once it's written down in the same order that they're giving it to. So I'm gonna write these down and I'll be right back. So as you can see, I've gone through and I've written down all 12. I'm gonna hit continue. So what they're doing here is they're asking for you to confirm the phrases that you have been given and the exact order that they gave it to you. So I'm going to write down, I'm going to type in what I've written down and hit continue. And it says your backup has been completed. You can see tips. You can do that on your own time. But for now, I'm going to hit maybe later. I'm going to call this demo teach wallet. Yeah. And I'm going to pick the strategic investor as my avatar. Hit confirm. And you now have access to your new wallet. As you can see in the upper left-hand corner, I have the demo teach wallet. That's the name of this wallet. On the right-hand side, I have the ETH gas meter. This is important and a useful tool to have. It helps you identify when it's a good time to do ETH transactions, when it's not. I have found in my personal experience that I'm not a really big fan of ETH. If you're holding it, that's awesome, but it's just very expensive and a lot of people find it very challenging to use. When it comes to sending your Ethereum. So for example, if you sent Ethereum, you purchased it on crypto.com and you wanted to send it to a specific place, if it's, there are times where if you wanted to send like $10 or $15, it's gonna cost you a lot of money just to send that. You're gonna pay a lot in gas fees. So this network would be probably in the yellow, the high yellow, or the middle of the red. So there's been many times where I wanted to send like $20 or $30 worth of Ethereum, and it was going to charge me $150 just to send my $30. So that would have been $170 total just to send my few dollars. And that doesn't make sense to me, but hopefully that will change pretty soon. But this whole normal network, this helps you identify when is a good time to, you know, make transactions with ETH. So that can be very helpful. This right here is a QR. So you can scan QR codes in order to make movement of money fast. So someone has a barcode. You can scan their barcode and send them money, basically. You have the send button, you have the receive button, and you have the buy button. So you can buy crypto from there. I'm gonna go back to that page because I hit the buy. But if you look down here on the bottom left, there's also buy also as well. And then you also have your Bitcoin wallet. So let me explain this real quick. Every crypto that you see here is cryptocurrency that has a different wallet. Okay, so what I'm saying is that your Bitcoin wallet is not going to be the same as Ethereum, and your Ethereum is not going to be the same as Kronos or Crow, and your Polkadot or DOT is not going to be the same as Near or vice versa. Each one of these have a different wallet. So I can go to receive. This says BC1Q at the beginning. But if I go out and I go to Ethereum, I go to receive, this is going to tell me the address I have. Notice it doesn't say the same as the BTC. It's totally different. 0x692, right? And so it's important for you to know that, you know, so because a lot of people think that all of these have the same address, but it does not. So be advised on that, right? I can show you on another video how you can import coins in here that aren't back here yet. And you can also send or hold NFTs back here. So if you wanted, you had some NFTs, you can send some NFTs here. I'll go over that in another video also. You can stake a lot of the tokens, but back here they're suggesting that you start staking Tectonic. That's another video we can do later on. Bridging through chains, that's another video we'll do later on. But you can deposit VVS after you purchase it, and you can make 17.90. I think that would be the annual, so ARP or APY, I think. Here's some news here you can look at on the bottom. You know, and these are quick buttons you can send or you can receive down here. We'll talk more about DApps later on. Swap, I'm gonna do a video on that very soon. And then the earn on the side, that's what you can use in order to put your crypto, you're staking it, and then it's giving you ROI over a certain period of time. So for the most part, that's what I wanted to show you is, oh, so if you go to demo teach wallet, or for you, it'd be something different. You can hit this and you can go to the back office, right? Or the back part of your app. You can come here to do your passcode. to do your enable touch ID. This means that it can scan your finger or your bio. I prefer not having that for the sake of training. I'm just doing it to go by fast. And then your two-factor authentication. That is another video I'm gonna do in regards to your Google authenticator. So we will set this up on another video another time, but you can turn it on when you're ready to do that. If you're not, you don't have to worry about it right now. So this is important too. You can connect to crypto.com app, but once you connect it, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, you can only connect it one time. So be advised on that. We'll go over the Web3 connection later on. That's another video also, because when you're connecting this wallet to different sites, it's going to confirm and stay connected, but it's going to show here. So I just wanted to show you that real quick. If you have any questions, if there's anything I can help you with, let me know. Like, subscribe, and or leave a comment below. And I look forward to helping you on this journey of making your crypto work harder for you than you have for it, and getting familiarized with the future of how money is going to be moved and how money will be made by decentralized finance, DeFi. It's no longer about necessarily about keeping your money in one place in the center. That's the center of power. It's all about it being fragmented, and or people are able to do transactions face to face, one-on-one, without the banks, without the middle person being in the middle and making their money and this and that. So this is an interesting and good time to see how money is progressing. But thank you for your time, thank you for watching, and I hope that this video has been informative for you, and you make it an awesome, magnificent day today. Take care.